Dead man. Dead men tell no tales. Except when they're spooky ghosts and hello, ladies and gentlemen, this is Bessa Slaughter. We are back playing a little bit more Horizon Zero Dawn. We're currently heading to the southeast, where we're going to go and do another cauldron. We're also going to grab a long, tall, necky, sauropody thing along the way. Very exciting stuff. Not done a cauldron since the first one, a very, very long time ago now, so this is long overdue, I think. And eventually we'll go back and do Zeta. Now that we have the rope caster, maybe I can take on the boss inside there. The boss that we are not going to talk about for a little while longer yet. Anywho. This is the 7th episode of this I've recorded today. I kind of didn't record it for like a whole 2 days and now it's so on the way that I can't resist. Oh, it's just so on the way. It could not be more on the way if it tried, you know? So the plan is bandit camp, into this, into that. This whole area here is very much unexplored. So it's probably about time we,
I'll find a use.
Explored it. Is that nil? I feel like that's nil. Or is it a bandit? Actually, I'm pretty sure it's a bandit. Well, it was a bandit. Quests, bandit camps. Is he not gonna hang around on this one? No. I guess Nil can't be here for all of... Oopsie-daisy, hello, didn't see you at all. There he is! I knew he wouldn't be able to resist. Right, we're going in hard on this one. Because every time we do it really sneakily, right, and it's fine. But it also takes a billion years. Sometimes you just wanna... Oh, okay. That dude I'm a little bit more scared about. Hello. Yes, hello, you are big and spooky, well done. Well, you're not that big and spooky, to be honest. Rubbish.
We're scrapped.
I feel like you shouldn't be able to fire that gun. Such close range, personally. But hey-ho. Hello, Poppet! La da 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 da. It just kind of speeds things up more than anything else. Tons of ammo. Lovely chubbly. Oh, okay. Right. Where are the rest of the bandits? The banditos. The bad boys. El Bandacabra. Or something. Stop me when I stop making sense. I have 3,000 shards. I am actually pretty loaded right now. What is that? They're all over here. Oh, hello. Loads of health potions, but really low in terms of medicine, so. A little hop down here. Hello. Not really what I was going for, but whatever. Ow.
It's a bloody rout!
Did I do it? I feel like I did it. Lovely jubbly. I don't like ending it crouching, because then she just sits there crouching like an absolute weirdo. Makes no sense. Sell. I definitely have some stuff I can sell, mainly weapons. Sell that. I can sell that. Is that it? I think that's it. Am I in like a lower level place? Because this dude's got less stuff than usual. Anyway, Now that that's done, lovely Geoblade, we're gonna head over to the east. What is this? Is that Nils? You know what? No, he's by a campfire. We can always fast travel back to him. I don't care about him. He's a nerd. And just because I'm a nerd doesn't mean I can't call other people nerds, okay? You're not a bandit, right? That wouldn't make any sense. Yeah. Okie dokie! Away we go. What's the quickest way out of here? Can I do this? Yes. I have no time for simple things like physics! Actually, where's this metal flat? Ah, it's not gonna stand there. Now, how am I gonna get on to... Run, because I'm pretty sure this is the way to do it. Stay there! Don't leave me! Oh, this is definitely not the way. Oh, well, there's a metal flower. That's much more obvious now that I know what I'm looking for. These flower patches. Very cool. Oh, I'm trying to see the thing. No. I actually think this is quite a low-level area. I guess I'm meant to be getting onto this central bit. We're going to ignore the snap moss, but pretend we don't see those. It's fine. Everything's okay. There's not a thing to worry about. Yes, there's giant metal crocodiles, but that's just part of life, you know. Part of life. Nothing to see here. Am I being chased? I feel like I'm being chased. Ah, whatever. What's the worst that could happen? Come on. Ah, that's more like it.
Feeling it's in another cauldron.
Run, no, I just missed it. Oh, we must wait. I really like the snap mods, they're very cool. Oh, I can do it from there as well. I'm not gonna get there in time, am I? No, not a chance in hell. Okay, well. Aha! Oh, we need fish. What? I can't remember quite what for, but I know we needed a fish bone, right? Or fish skin, or... We needed a fish. I remember needing a fish. And now that's a green, so we've got a green and a blue, so no matter what it was, we have enough to do it. Actually, it would have been in my crafting. I really, really wish it showed you if you had enough to do these. I need two fish bones for that. Booker. Being able to carry more potions is definitely a positive. I've already got 5, but we're going to go up to 9 now. Which is going to make a lot of this game a little bit easier, I think. So many stam mods, bloody Nora. I really just think I'm going to have to wait. Right, we'll do that and then... Yeah, and then we'll head east and do that. Okay. Oh, what level is that corrupted zone? Sorry, stop looking at things. Just wait. It is very cool. Big fan of your work, friend. Big fan. Still don't like my hat, though. Hello, you up there. Are you Stormbird? I need to kill... Oh, yes, man. I do need to kill a Stormbird, so if we happen to spot one. And a blimmin' T-Rex. Oh, go away. You're not interested, are you? They really can't see me when I'm like this. Crouched and in my stealth armor. I'm basically invisible. Take your time, friendo. You are lovely. Really, the only reason I'm willing to let you off for taking so quite so bloody long. She must be boiling in this outfit, by the way. Really only just not. Look how furry it is. It's too furry.
Okay, time to climb up to its head.
Not a problem. Probably. What's the worst I could- well, I could fall to my death. Lovely jubbly! Override that! And then we can head to the cauldron. Hopefully unlock the ability to override some pretty cool stuff. I imagine maybe it's things in the area, so it might be like Star Wars or stuff like that. Seems like an overreaction. Right, we are heading in that direction. They are very cool. I don't think you really get... oh, you get a skill point every time you do it, so it's actually worth doing. And I believe there's only one more in the game. It is very nice being rewarded with skill points. Kind of leads into my whole thing of hoping I'll be able to get every skill in the game, otherwise I'm going to be extremely upset because I want them all. Turkey! I know we need a turkey. Oh, that's not a turkey. Well, it's a turkey, but it only glowed white, not green or blue, so I know we didn't get anything valuable. I know we need a fox as well, as it happens. Said we need a fox! Don't you run away from me! It's only a bloody sawtooth. It's like basic level stuff at this point in time. I just don't care.
Keep that for later.
I'm going the right way, right? Yep. When we get a little closer, this should pop up on my map and I'll be able to set it. Until then, we just enjoy the lovely atmosphere, because it is gorgeous. I would take it home to meet my mum. God only knows what she'd say. She'd just be glad I'm bringing somebody home, even if it is a video game, but... there you go. Cauldron Row. Okay, quest log. Talk to me, quest. Oh, level 11, that is beautiful. Wonder what the final boss is going to be. The first one was a yellow billow back. I imagine maybe a Ravager on one of them, maybe. A Thunderjaw on one of them, maybe. God only knows. I've done like a jumping attack before, but it never seems to work anymore. Lovely jubbly. Worth getting the critical hit when you can, just for the extra 100 XP, really. Not too worried about burning for medicine either, because these places always have a ton of mushrooms in. And mushrooms means medicine. Ooh, Nelly. Okay, maybe we'll go the slightly slower way down instead of plummeting into the chasm. I know, I'm edgy like that, what can I say? The game is definitely stuck in me up.
Through that pipe.
What pipe? I will see you in a second. Oh, this is a very different opening than the last one we did, isn't it? There's water down there, right? Probably. There is, but it's not shallow water. Oh, it is shallow water. It's a little bit too shallow, as it happens.
Looks
it's
like
fine.
First to look for a way in. What a waste.
Oh, dead man. That men tell no tales. Except when they're spooky ghosts. In which case they tell lots of tales. Usually spooky ghost ones. Oh, for God's sake, Connor. Stop burning for all your health.
Too. I'm better prepared.
Alright. Very curious as to what this enemy is going to be. It's only a level 12 on this, and we are nearly level 30. However, the levels in this game seem... not off, but... I don't know what I mean. Ah!
Looks like things are going my way.
Ah! I like that. That's very cool. Bit slow, but cool. Lovely. Lovely, lovely, lovely.
That rushing sound again.
I love this. These tunnels of wires. It's very, very cool. Let's play some bets. I'm gonna bet... oh, I don't know. I actually can't think of what the final enemy would be. It's gotta be bigger than a Bellowback. Shellwalker? No, because we had a Shellwalker as an enemy before the Bellow back in the last place, you know? I can't really think. I'm going to guess Ravager. But... God only knows. God only knows, really. But I am going to guess Ravager. Can I do this any quicker? Am I going the right way? Oh no, that feels like it's going to kill me. Yeah, that's killing me. Ow, 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 ow! Okay, we don't get up from this way. Good to know! Good to know! Oh! Oh, hello! Where are my fire arrows? Alright, calm down. It's weird, right? I have a lot of health, but I still feel like I take a hit. This is a sawtooth, for God's sake. This is like a really basic level enemy, but if it gets some hits on you, you're just kind of screwed. That's a sawtooth, right? Oh, it's a Ravager, that's why. I don't know. I feel like I need more defensive armor. I might go for... oh, but I really like being... oh. I think I'm going to get the melee repellent armor, though. Not that we're going to use it all the... can I go... yeah, I can do that. Not going to use it all the time, but I think the melee repellent armor is a good idea. Grand. I can do this, right? Oh, no, no, no. Down. Seems we have to go up this way. Yeah, yeah, I think that's the plan. Melee, but then, I know the final armor in the game is like a shield, right? It's like really shieldy and melee resistant, so I kind of just don't want to get more melee resistant when I'm going to get better melee resistant, you know? Anyways. Now what? Aha! Jam my pole in there. Give it a little wiggle. There we go. Bridge, right? Yep. Okay. You know what? I don't need you to reverse polarity. I can do anything. Even this. Actually, this does seem to make a mockery of the idea of the polarity, because what's the point? Eh, whatever.
Alright, that should get me through.
Lovely! Lovely, 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 lovely. Oh, do I need to? I need to go back, don't I? Hop onto one of those things. That's going to take me through. Yep, cool. And now the priority's gone the right way. See, it was all planned. This was all my plan from the start. Somebody will believe me, right? It's not totally not believable that I wouldn't plan something out for the first time in my life. Why not take a risk? He looks terrifying like that. Okay. Nope. Right. Ah. Hello. Wait. Is this gonna... This looks like it's gonna... Yeah, that looks like a bad idea. Am I meant to go... Am I meant to be... Can I jump that, maybe? Yeah, okay. Don't know why I didn't do that in the first place, but hey-ho. Oopsie daisy. My bad. But then I got to slip and slide into a silent strike, so yeah. Take the good with the bad. I know there's at least one more up here. But I suppose it doesn't actually matter. Oh, hello. Oh, some blaze, finally. And some echo shells, that's good stuff. 9 of them as well, that's crazy. And 189 metal shards! I don't think I was actually necessarily meant to come up here. Like, obviously I was, but I feel like this was meant to be, potentially a little bit sneaky, you know? Hello! How I can do that when it's very clearly seeing me, I don't know, but I'm not complaining. Right, what's my plan here then? I can get up there. Let's go there. I think this might just be a loop bit. I've got to stop doing that. I really, really have to stop doing that. Oh, this does look like the right way.
The machines collect blaze from the wilds. And it all flows here, like blood to a heart. So the cauldron runs in life itself.
Well, we knew that, the machines... Oh, hello, Poppet. Kind of used organic matter. In order to feed.
Keep working on my spear in the cauldrons. Maybe I
could override that. Okay. Ah, wait. There we go. Hello! You're a silly little so-and-so. Oh, that's a Ravager. Fantastic. Okay. This is fine. This is fine. Oh my god. Okay, this isn't as fine as I thought it was.
Thank you.
Yeah, a bit late for that, Aloy. Little bit late for that. And by a little bit, I mean crazy too late for that. Alright, can we calm down with the trying to kill me thing? Because that's enough, you know? It's just enough. I kind of wanted to finish this video with the actual killing of the boss, so we need to get a move on. Let's work out how I'm going to get across there, though. Right now, I don't actually know. Can I climb up? Is there a bridge somewhere I'm missing, maybe? Or a bridge thing, one of those big red holes? Aha, there it is. Hello, puppet. Give me a sec, love. And you! Shut up. There we go. Okay. Blaze processing plant is shut down, I guess. It looks promising, doesn't it? Bloody Nora, Aloy. Again, I have to stop doing that. Ah, right. Find Cauldron Core.
The belly of this giant beast.
Yes, finally. Cauldron Core is where the bosses are. Suspect I wasn't meant to do. Oh well. I know, Aloy. I'm sorry. I am trying to keep you relative. I wasn't meant to go down there. I mean, there's no reason to think I can't go down there. Right, it just looked like a flaw. Slight mistakes may have been made. Not gonna pretend otherwise. Didn't go quite as well as anticipated. What are you gonna do? Alright, so okay. The game has pulled me back about 20 seconds.
The belly of this giant beast.
I didn't go this way last time, did I? Where did I go last time? What's wrong with me? Why would I not go this way? Oh, whatever. I just want to see what this boss is going to be. It can't be a Ravager. We just fought a Ravager. What's slightly bigger? Maybe a Behemoth. That's what I'm putting my hat on. Behemoth. New prediction.
That's where I need to go.
Well, it's down there. What is it? Is it a Snapmore? I think it's a Snapmore. Yes, it's a Snapmore. Interesting. I guess, I mean, I predicted earlier that it would be a creature that basically we would unlock the ability to tame a Snapmore from this. Because of all the Snapmores in the area. So I'm guessing the creature in the middle is always one that you'd... I don't know, could we tame thingies? The belly ones? I didn't think we could. Oh well, it's only a Snapmore, this should be easy. Unless it's like a high level Snapmore, unless it's like particularly difficult to kill Snapmore, which I imagine could definitely be the case. But I'm not that worried. Right now, I'm not that worried. See where we stand in a couple of minutes. Now, there is usually... Yeah, it's very unopposing, isn't it? Yeah, I was going to say, there's usually a couple of watchers nearby. This is fine. Okay. Now we just need to gather some health items up, and we will be good to party. This is the way up, and there's usually lots of health things in the nearby area.
Handy.
Now, how do we kill Snapmore? It's Blaze, isn't it? Yeah. Because they are... You know, I don't even need this. We're fine. We can do this after the kill. PC, stop beeping at me. Hup. I'm feeling very confident, and that worries me slightly. Like, if this is a normal Snapmore, it will be easy. If it's anything other than a normal Snapmore, it won't be. But I'd count Ravagers as more difficult than Snapmores. So that's what's confusing me. Oh, there's a Ravager as well as a Snapmore. That would explain a lot. Okay. I take back everything. Yeah, I quite obviously did not see the Ravager, otherwise... Yeah. That should be dead, right? Maybe not time to loot it, though. Hello! One of these days, I'm gonna run out of Blaze and this game is gonna become substantially more difficult for me. But for now, that was very, very easy. Like, that could not be much easier. It's done, right? You're not gonna throw anything else at me. I'm just gonna do some quick looting. Got a freeze coil as well. That's cool. We don't really use the freeze arrows much. There's not much that's weak against the freeze arrows, and that's really the only reason. Like, most of the higher level creatures seem to be ice-based for some, for whatever reason. I don't really know. What was that? It's not the thing that brought me down in the first place. Oh, I love these places. They just throw mushrooms at you. That might sound bad, but it's very helpful. Right. Into the middle then. Let's override the core and upgrade our stick. Guessing Snapmore and Ravager. Based on the fact we just fought a Snapmore and a Ravager.
That's it. More machines I can override.
You're going to tell me what? I've got a skill point, though. You're not going to tell me what, are you? Ah! Trampler, Shellwalker, Snapmore, Longleg, Ravager. Yeah. Level 30, multiple new skill points. We've got 5 skill points! That's crazy! It's crazy! I'm curious as to how much you get from that. It looks like you get quite a lot more. I'm gonna grab that. It's a way to test. I'm not really gonna be able to test, am I? Okay! Ladies and gentlemen! Right, next episode, what are we gonna do? What are we gonna do? Actually, my capacity is... I'm actually near our capacity. I'm gonna have to clear some stuff out at some point. Like, we don't need 5,000 pieces of wire. Right. So, we got our main quest. We've got two main quests. Two quests at Pitchcliff. We have our hunting grounds to do. And the Stormbird Thunderjaw trophy. And this random collateral one that I don't really care about, if I'm being honest. We might go try out these hunting trials. We might go do... I think we're going to go do that. I think we're going to go do the other cauldron. I am tempted to try this one up in Zeta. Because it's really short to get to. You know, it takes like no time to get to Zeta. Not get to, but the actual... Because I got to the final boss of Zeta. But actually going in, it's a very short experience. You don't have to do much to get there. To the actual final boss. It's not like this one where we went through this whole platforming puzzly bit. It was a very short journey. So, I am slightly tempted now that we've got a good rope caster to give that another go. Oh, but it kicked my ass so hard. It's really hard to decide. We will see. We might just do some main quests. We might just do the hunting trials. We might go to the hunting grounds, which we've not really done this. There's one there, and there's one there. So we actually have all 5 hunting grounds available to us. And we get really good weapons from doing that. So maybe that should be our goal for next few episodes. Get ourselves ready and upgraded before we tackle the main mission, of which there's about 7 left, I had a little look, and before we tackle the other cauldrons. Everything else in terms of side missions, we're going to not ignore, but not worry about too much. I'm more going to worry about cauldrons, hunting trials, and then main quest. I think that's the roundabout goal. Yeah? Yeah, cool. Thank you for joining me. Cheers. Much love. As always. Bye-bye.